What's going on, everyone? Today I'm here with Mike Ojo. Now, this brother is a pilot. Yes, we are talking to a black pilot today. That is very awesome because, you know, we always hear about brothers being rappers and ball players, but we don't hear too many brothers piloting planes. So I want to thank Michael Jones on the show today.
No worries. Glad to be here.
Man, you just laid back, brother. You just real laid back. You that chill all the time?
Pretty much. Pretty much, except maybe when I'm out trying to fly something, but I'm this way 99% of the time. So,
okay. So obviously, you say you went to you're flying planes. What got you interested in that?
Since I was six, I remember we used to walk to school back in Lagos, and we actually live very close to an airport. So I would see planes fly by me, and I remember just being so envious of whoever was in that plane. So I would say since I was like 6, 7, I've always been fascinated about airplanes. And I got in one the first time when I was probably 12 years old. So it's sort of been in the back of my mind ever since I was a kid. And then I didn't get my license until maybe 20 years later, close to that. So. But it's just fascination since I was a kid. I've always been fascinated with airplanes.
Now, let me ask you a question. When you went to flight school, now, right. is that really difficult? I mean, because there may be some people watching that's like, man, I would feel that in my heart, too. The same thing you felt. I want to fly a plane. So is it difficult? Or, I mean, how is school itself?
Honestly, it's how you approach it. I would say that it was one of the most challenging things that I'd ever done until that time. So it's really how you approach it. And that's why I created my YouTube channel to sort of share my story on how my process went and the things that I went through and the mistakes that I made, things like that. But it doesn't have to be difficult. It's how you approach it. If you approach it the right way, you come prepared, things like that, you should be fine.
So when you did get through school, is it something that's very expensive?
Oh, yeah. So that's another part of aviation that I would say that's a little bit intimidating. So right now it is expensive, mainly because of the cost to I would say, gas up the airplane. Mm-hmm. So fuel, for example, is one of the most expensive part of flying. And that cost obviously is driven down to the pilot or the student. So it is expensive, but there are always ways around it. You can always find ways around it rather than just, you know, paying whatever it is that's the average price. There's always ways around where you can either fly for free, you can get scholarships, you can always get a loan. And don't go to an expensive school or try to fly like a fancy plane. So that was one of the mistakes that I made. I should have just went for the old beat up planes and learned how to fly in those than trying to fly, you know, the most modern airplane out there. So there are ways to cut your costs.
Now, let me ask you a question. Now, you say you fly in flight school. Now, when you want to get to the point that you're flying the 747s or even to the point like an Airbus or whatever, do you got to go to a different school to get to that level?
Well, yes and no. You don't have to go to a different school. You can always stay with the same school. So every school will have different programs. So you can, a lot of schools actually train you all the way to, you know, ATP, which is commercial flying for airliners. And if you like the school, just stay with them. But if you go to like a mom and pop school, which is a lot of what you find around here, you can get maybe a private with that school and then advance to a different school that they have much more advanced, broader programs. But the key actually to getting that far is just building time, because there's a minimum requirement before you can, you know, even get an interview to become an airline pilot. So you just got to work on building time.
Okay, so how do you build your time?
Fly as much as you can. Now, the best way that I think people go about that is, so say for example, right now what I have is just called a private pilot license, and that allows me to fly a single engine small airplane. If I wanted to go further and I said, okay, I want to become an airline pilot, then what I would start doing is just fly the little airplanes for as much as I can. And then I could get my commercial license and that would, I can get hired. So for example, this is how people do it. They would get a commercial license and then become an instructor, a CFI. And so when you become an instructor, you basically get paid to fly. And all those times that you're instructing and teaching other people how to fly, that time also goes into your logbook. So you have a lot of students go that route where they become a CFI, and within a year or 2 years, they're able to build enough time and then move on to the airliners.
Okay, so a company like, for instance, your JetBlues or your Delta, Southwest, whatever, how much time you need to become a pilot with one of them?
I think the last I checked, there's a minimum requirement of 1500 hours. So, excuse me. Now, actually, the last 2 years or so, there's been a shortage in pilots, believe it or not. So, you have some smaller regional airliners that are reducing the amount of time you need. But I think on average, you probably need about 1500 hours to get in the doors to fly for like Delta or JetBlue.
Okay, so in your case, is that the route you're gonna go? You're trying to become the
No.
instructor? No.
So yeah, it's I wanted to initially, honestly, like when I first got my license, it was just a matter of achieving a long time goal or dream. And I thought about going all the way, to commercial, to airlines, but then I got married and I discussed with my wife, and it's not, because when you think of airline pilots, the lifestyle is very different. You're not home most of the time, and you get to fly all different hours of the day. So that lifestyle would not, I guess, match the type of lifestyle that I want to have. So the simple answer is no. I wouldn't. I'm not planning to go all the way to commercial and fly for the airliners.
Well, you said something about you got married, and
Right.
I'm gonna tell you about that. It is marriage shouldn't stop anything that you want to do, or even if you have a dream, right? But you have your partner, and you tell like I say, she got her ideas, you got your ideas. But I think it would be good, like I say, just my opinion, just as another brother. I think it'd be good for you to at least get to the point where you're flying private jets, because look at the money you can make maybe flying people like ball players, celebrities, or whoever else. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to work for Southwest if you're good enough to have, get your own private jet and start flying people around. I mean, that's good money. I
Right.
mean,
So there's the thing. So when you think about flying in general, it's always about your mission and what you want to use the license for. And personally, for me, getting a license is about freedom. Freedom to be at point A or point B whenever I want. And in terms of, the going commercial and getting paid to fly, I hear you, and honestly, that's what I promote also on my channel, where I try to discuss what you need to go commercial. But I have a lot of pilot friends, and when I talk to them, it's not always the same. So like right now, I can get an airplane fly and I'm having fun and I'm chill. But when you're doing it for work, it's a different game. It's different, it's not as fun. And you have to work on a different schedule and whatnot. But the truth is, there is money to be made. You can always fly either for big airliners or you can fly for, business jets and things like that. So, but to be honest with you, I'm actually thinking of maybe getting a commercial license, but it wouldn't be to fly for, to get paid to fly. It would be more to teach, because my ultimate goal is to promote aviation and basically, get more people in the door. I would love to see more people, especially more people who look like me. I'm almost 30 and I travel a lot. I still have not seen once someone who looks like me in a pilot suit. And that's honest truth. When I fly commercial, even when I travel state to state, I've never seen a black person in a pilot suit. And that's even hard to say it out loud. I hear myself say it. So my part of my goal is to to be able to inspire other people, especially minorities, to get in the door and not think that it's something that's out of reach, or it's something that because they don't see other people who look like them doing it. Because that was part of what happened to me. It took almost 20 years for me to finally say, I'm gonna do this. And part of it was because I never thought it was for me, because I never saw anyone who looked like me doing it. So
Well, I'm gonna tell you what. Have you flown Ethiopian Airlines?
no, I haven't.
Okay, well, that's like the first time like in my life, and I just thought, I was like, man, this is cool. You got to see just everybody that that's from the continent doing everything, right? And like I said, I think they had a air. I think there was a Airbus that they flew when we went over there, and that's why I was saying you ever thought about flying internationally. Because sometime in the States, you know how it is in the States, brother. You know how it is with the racism, and we know that. But from what I was to told, that they're gonna have to have more airline companies, right, on the continent, because they need more flights in between the different African countries. And they say whoever's going to facilitate that is going to become mega rich, or going to become a billionaire. So what I'm saying out of that is, you may not want to do it, but there's so much opportunity on the continent of Africa for flights, because a lot of flights got to go through either Ireland, some sort of European nation, and then come to the continent instead of having direct flights. You know what I'm saying? Or even
Right.
flights. So let's say if you're flying from Kenya to Ghana, they don't have flights like that too much. So, I'm just saying, just think about it, because I mean, everybody else is going to Africa and making money. Well, how can you go make some money?
I hear you, and believe it or not, just recently I've had people reach out to me from Lagos. They're trying to open a flight school. But to speaking to your point though, and we touched on this earlier, one of the reasons when you think of aviation in general, and when you think of Africa as a continent, aviation here in America, we already feel like it's expensive, but it's even more expensive over there. Or you have situations where they don't even have enough resources. Because I know quite a few pilots in my circle where they're international students, and their only purpose was to come here and train and learn how to fly. Because in their countries, either the training is too expensive, or the rules and regulation is too strict. So the freedom to learn the skill is here. Now, in terms of making money, again, trust me, it's something I think about all the time, but there's a business side to things. And if I would say go that route, or even work with people, or try to start my own gig out there, say if I wanted to open up something in Lagos, Nigeria, for example, it's a different world, it's a different culture, and there are different rules out there. So it will take time, but it is something that I definitely think about, from time to time.
Yeah, man. I just like to see brothers, like you said. And the reason why I'm just kind of encouraging it, because you have a skill that not too many black people have. Let's call it what it is. We don't have those skills. And to say you have that skill, you can fly planes, whether you want to do it domestically here in the US, or you want to go do things on the continent of Africa, or wherever you want to go, I mean, it's like the world's really opened up to you. And that's why I'm just thinking, you got a family and XYZ, you can put your family up in a position that maybe you never had. So that's just why I think like that a lot on that aspect. But like I said, you gotta do what your heart leads you to do, and that's what you should do. I'm just happy for you. I'm proud to
Appreciate that. I appreciate that.
I'm so
Thank you.
proud to hear that you did it. 'Cause there's a lot of brothers that didn't do it, man. A lot of us, didn't make it, and so it's good to hear, you made it, you got a family, that's beautiful. So Mike, tell me, how can people get to your YouTube channel?
My YouTube channel is called Mojo Grip. It's spelled Mojogrip. You can just Google search it, or just go to youtube.com/MojoGrip. And there you find everything you can possibly find on airplanes, on flying, whatever you can. And I've been getting more serious about creating the content for the channel, and hopefully I'll be able to build on it. And just another thing to speak on what you said earlier about, black people in general, not being able to do this. I can tell you since I started the channel, I've had at least 4 to 5 people reach out to me, and they started their journey. They went for a demo flight. I actually had one of my viewers sent me a video on my Instagram 2 days ago. He did his first solo, and this guy is based in Poland. He's based in Poland, and he said, "Listen, I started watching your videos, and it inspired me to start flying." And he sent me a video of him going on his first solo. So
You say it's a
something like
black
that,
guy? Hold on,
it's
hold
just
on. Not to
amazing.
cut you off. You say it's a black guy in Poland?
Yes, a black guy in
Is his
Poland.
name O'Shea?
No, that's not his name. His screen name start with an S, but.
Okay, I thought it was O, because I know, because the only one I know in Poland that's black is O'Shea Duke Jackson. That's all. Wonder
I
if
don't know
it
O'Shea, but yeah, when I get
was him.
messages like that, though, it's amazing to see. Okay, like I'm not just doing this, or I'm not just putting myself out there for nothing. People are watching. People are actually seeing that this is something I can do, and just in general, outside of race and everything, I feel like there's a stigma around flying in general, and I love to break those, beliefs that, oh, it's hard, or it's expensive, or it's not for me, or it's only for rich people, things like that. I like to break those gates down and basically get more people in. And the fact is, the more people that are flying, the cheaper it's going to get for everybody.
Yes,
The
sir.
reason why it's so expensive right now is because very few people are doing it.
Yes, sir. So definitely, guys, we'll make sure to put his YouTube channel in the pinned comment so you guys can go over there, maybe ask him some questions, watch his videos. Make sure you subscribe. I mean, give the brothers some subscribers. Encourage them to keep creating content. We need more brothers out there and sisters. We definitely need. What was that? The first sister that was flying. What was her name again? I did a video on her years ago. My mind went blank. It was
Was this
Bessie.
Kimberly by any chance?
Do what?
Was her name Kimberly?
No, it's Bessie something. I forgot her name. Yeah, I forgot that sister name. I did a video on her long ago, and her name just—I know it's Bessie something. But she was the first black woman to fly. But we need.
I think your viewers should also check out Kimberly. I think her name is Adike. Believe it or not, that was the person who inspired me to finally go and do it. She was this young teenage girl in California, and she flew cross country. And I remember hearing and watching her story, and I'm like, I have no excuse. I have no excuse. I have to do this. So you guys should check her out also. She's amazing.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. We definitely want to thank Mike for joining us on the show today. Your brother, take care of the family, and let us know if you want to open up that flight school, because that'd be awesome if you choose to do that.
Thinking about it, I'll definitely let you know.
All right, brother.